Hi there. Welcome back to my shop. It's been a while, I know. I've got three things I want to show you today. First thing, you're going to probably think I'm showing off, but I have a brand new chemo haircut. It's all fallen out, and don't worry, I won't take off the do-rag. It's not my intention to scare anyone, okay? Second thing is this Comgrow laser enclosure. Nobody sent this to me to ask me to review it. I bought this with my own dime, and I'm quite happy with it. I got the large one because I want to be able to put a light burn camera in there with the laser, and of course I need the height to do that. Now let me open this up here and I'll show you. It was quite easy to put together. There are some of these tubes that are two pieces, and you just put those together in the proper configuration. Fairly decent instructions to do that. One thing, if you decide to get one of these, number two are the ones that are in the front. I was trying to get the number one to go in there, but once I shifted it, it worked a lot better. So I'm happy with this. It comes with a lot of features as far as panels that'll open up so you can bring things in and out from here. Some good sized ones, some smaller ones, so you can just push your data and power cables through. There are quite a number of those. One in the top that I fed the cable, the wire for the light. And the light does a nice job in there. So without a whole bunch of looking at this, I think you can see it's a pretty good unit. I'm quite happy with it. All right, so one thing, the only thing on this that I think I would have preferred is if they used some of that orange plastic instead of the clear plastic, so you would not have to wear the safety goggles made for lasers. And I always use these even when I have something else blocking the light, just to be sure that everything's safe, so I'm not too unhappy with that. Another thing I purchased is this inline 4-inch duct fan to take the smoke out of this fitting, and I've got a 50-foot 4-inch hose on here so I can feed it out through underneath my garage door. So that's very handy. Now that's a quick look at it. I don't know if you can even hear this, but that's the fan, and it does take a lot of that air out of there. All right, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the Creality Fusion 2 12-watt laser to engrave and cut something. So I will get that set up in here, get the laptop and everything ready to go, and I'll be right back. Now I believe I said I was using a Creality Fusion 2. I don't know where that came from. As you can see, it's actually the Falcon 2. Now this is a 12-watt laser engraver, so it has to run a little slower and with more power to do the things that the 20 and 40-watt will do. But it still does a nice job, and I'm going to show that to you now. I'm going to drop down this shield. Make sure that the smoke is going out through that hose rather than coming into the shop through an open door here. All right, now I'm going to be engraving this at 4,000 millimeters per minute and 60% power, and then cutting out that outside red circle that I think you can probably see here at 350 millimeters per minute and 100% power. So let's frame this to make sure we're in the right spot. And start the burn. And this is going to take more than 12 minutes, so I will certainly be speeding this up. I don't know if it's showing up on the camera, but the smoke going out that hose is certainly visible. All right, I'll just give it a few seconds for the smoke to clear out. Then I'll turn off that fan and we'll take a look at what we have here. Okay, now let's see what this turned out like. All right, falls right out of there. And it's a nice engraving. I'm just going to use some compressed air, see what this looks like after I blow that dust away. All right, I'm quite pleased with that. I think that turned out about as well as I could expect. 12 watt engraver does a very nice job. 1/8 inch or 3 millimeter birch plywood. I can't complain about that. And I'm very pleased with this enclosure. Does a great job of keeping the smoke from billowing all over the shop. All right, you may notice right away that I replaced the inline 4-inch fan that I had with this 6-inch unit. I just didn't think it was moving quite enough air. It was moving at 130 CFM, where this one's doing 390. So I purchased this and the adapters to go to the 4-inch hose, and I quite like what it's doing. Now, I decided I wanted to play a little more with this engraver. I was having a lot of fun with it. So of course I had to do my putty tat. You wouldn't want me to not show you that. And then I bought a 12-inch mandala that was designed by Tim Ung. I reduced it to 4-inch, and what you might find amazing is just how small these holes around the inner diameter are. I mean, they are just pinpricks, basically, and they cut so beautifully, it's amazing. So putting this up to the 12-inch mandala might be quite beautiful. And of course, still got the logo. So I hope you enjoyed this video, got something out of it. I will put links down below in the description box to all these things that I purchased, and maybe you'll want to take advantage of that. So now, between today and next time I come around, I hope you'll have a great day in your shop and be safe. If you enjoy what I'm doing, please subscribe. It helps my channel out. And click the like button if you enjoyed this one. Take care now. Bye-bye.